Officials at Mount Hebron High School say there's no rat infestation there. They do admit some rats or a rat has been seen, and they insist they're working to get rid of the rodents. 11 News reporter Reba Hollingsworth joins us live from Ellicott City with the latest. Reba.
Well, school officials sent out an email to parents saying the school doesn't have a rat problem, but they also say rats have been found at this school.
This is absolutely false. There is absolutely no truth to this headline.
The Howard County school system is firing back, challenging an article in The Examiner, an article that claims six rats fell from the ceiling in the cafeteria at Mount Hebron High School.
There's no attribution in the article as well, so we do not even know where they got this information.
School officials admit a rat was found in the courtyard this school year. The county's health department and the school's pest specialists were out at the school today looking for rats. They found babies in the courtyard, but none in the cafeteria or the ceiling.
And it could be that this one rat in the courtyard somehow blew up, to become six rats in the cafeteria.
Rat problem or not, Mount Hebron is back in the spotlight. The 40-plus-year-old school has had its share of problems. Just last year, the aging school had to deal with leaky ceilings. Some teachers at the school have even signed a petition to push for renovations. A $50 million renovation proposal will go to the school board next week.
You know, there's more to the school than just what it looks like.
Deb Cruzy hopes to send her two young kids to Mount Hebron. She says it's up to the community to make sure the renovations happen.
Even if I didn't have kids, to make sure that the county is doing what needs to be done, to keep it up to code, to make it a place where people want to bring their kids.
Well, bait boxes have been put out in the courtyard, and school officials say they hope to have this problem fixed by the end of the weekend. In Howard County, I'm Reba Hollingsworth, WBAL-TV 11 News.